ದಿ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಚಾರ್ಟರ್ಡ್ ಅಕೌಂಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಉಡುಪಿ ಶಾಖೆ ಆಶ್ರಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಲೆಕ್ಕ ಪರಿಶೋಧಕರ ದಿನಾಚರಣೆಯನ್ನು ಸೋಮವಾರ ಉಡುಪಿ ಕರಾವಳಿ ಬೈಪಾಸ್ನ ಮಣಿಪಾಲ್ ಇನ್ ಹೋಟೆಲ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಅದ್ದೂರಿಯಾಗಿ ಆಚರಿಸಲಾಯಿತು. ಉದ್ಯಮಿ ಇಬ್ರಾಹಿಂ ಮೌಲಾನಾ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದ ಮುಖ್ಯ ಅತಿಥಿಯಾಗಿ ಭಾಗವಹಿಸಿ ಮಾತನಾಡಿ, ಉದ್ಯಮ ಉದ್ಯಮಿಯ ಯಶಸ್ಸಿನ ಹಿಂದೆ ಲೆಕ್ಕ ಪರಿಶೋಧಕರ ಸಲಹೆ ಸೂಚನೆ ಪ್ರಮುಖ ಪಾತ್ರವನ್ನು ನಿರ್ವಹಿಸುತ್ತದೆ. ಪ್ರಸ್ತುತ ಲೆಕ್ಕ ಪರಿಶೋಧಕರ ಬೆಂಬಲವಿಲ್ಲದೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ಉದ್ಯಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಏಳಿಗೆ ಕಾಣುವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯವಿಲ್ಲ. ಪ್ರಾಮಾಣಿಕ ತೆರಿಗೆ ಪಾವತಿ, ಉದ್ಯಮದಲ್ಲಿ ನಂಬಿಕೆ ಉಳಿಸಿಕೊಂಡಾಗ ಉತ್ತುಂಗ ಶಿಖರಕ್ಕೆ ಏರುವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯವಿದೆ. ನನ್ನ ಯಶಸ್ಸಿನ ಹಿಂದೆ ಚಾರ್ಟರ್ಡ್ ಅಕೌಂಟೆಂಟ್ಗಳ ಪಾತ್ರ ಮಹತ್ತರವಾಗಿದೆ ಎಂದರು. ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದ ಉದ್ಘಾಟನೆ ನೆರವೇರಿಸಿ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಎಚ್ವಿ ಸುಧಾಕರ್ ನಾಯಕ್ ಅವರು ಶಿಕ್ಷಣದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾಹಿತಿ ನೀಡಿದರು. ಈ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಉಡುಪಿ ಶಾಖೆಯ ಹಿರಿಯ ಸದಸ್ಯರಾದ ಸಿಎ ಕೆ ಭೋಜಶೆಟ್ಟಿ, ಸಿಎ ಕೆ ನರಸಿಂಹಕಿಣಿ, ಸಿಎ ಕೆ ಪದ್ಮನಾಭ ಕಾಂಚನ್ ಹಾಗೂ ಸಿಎ ಪ್ರದೀಪ್ ಜೋಗಿ ಅವರನ್ನು ಸನ್ಮಾನಿಸಲಾಯಿತು. ಉಪಾಧ್ಯಕ್ಷೆ ಅರ್ಚನಾ ಆರ್ಮಯ್ಯ, ಕಾರ್ಯದರ್ಶಿ ಎಂ ರಾಘವೇಂದ್ರ ಮೊಗೆರಾಯ, ಕೋಶಾಧಿಕಾರಿ ಅಶ್ವಥ್ ಜೆ ಶೆಟ್ಟಿ, ಸಿಕಾಸಾ ಅಧ್ಯಕ್ಷೆ ಕೆ ಲಕ್ಷ್ಮೀ ಶ್ರಾವ್, ನಿಕಟಪೂರ್ವ ಅಧ್ಯಕ್ಷ ಲೋಕೇಶ್ ಶೆಟ್ಟಿ ಉಪಸ್ಥಿತರಿದ್ದರು. ಸಿಎ ರಾಘವೇಂದ್ರ ಮೊಗೇರಯ್ಯ ಮತ್ತು ಲೋಕೇಶ್ ಶೆಟ್ಟಿ ಕಾರ್ಯನಿರೂಪಿಸಿದರು. ಸಭಾ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದ ಬಳಿಕ ಸಾಂಸ್ಕೃತಿಕ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ನಡೆಯಿತು.
Examination of Chartered Accountant course, continuing professional education of members, conducting post qualification courses, formulation of accounting standards.
Sudhakar Naik, he done his PhD in Metallurgical Engineering, Indian Institute of Science, Bengaluru. He has experience of more than 45 years in teaching.
wherever any new projects, I am asking him first. As a brother, not as a chartered accountant, as a brother I am asking. So down to earth, so simplified person I got in my life. So I am seeing more, you know, every day different dream. Today we have leased out this hotel because it was totally different activity for me from my seafood sector. It was not possible for me to run. Several times I discussed with Kiran Kumar and I was telling him, see, I want to dispose this because I cannot run. But he is the only person who is to always, you know, from my back he is to say, don't worry, you are going to gain from that. You are going to improve everything from here and you are going to get better than what you are thinking today. This kind of CA is there for what to, how, why I should worry about my future and future projects and everything. And you know, many times I used to discuss about the politics, which you know, discuss about the present financial scenario. We used to discuss about finance minister. We used to discuss about the finance policies. Because I was in the Ministry of Commerce, appointed me as an authority, embedded authority member. I was a nominated gazetted officer for 3 years. Where my intention is not to think about myself. I wanted my industry, my colleagues in my industry, seafood industry, I want them also to grow. Because I don't want to, you know, always I think that I don't want to be a selfish person. We learn a lot. You know, yesterday I was in Cochin, Mr. Kiran. I met the dean of Arabic Science University of Oman. And he is a seafood exporter. In 7 days, every weekend, Thursday he is flying back to India and Saturday he is going back to home, Saturday evening flight, because Sunday onwards the classes start, 5 days in the business. And I was discussing with him, he has 3-4 plants in Cochin. So he was telling me it is his ancestral business, like his father started 40 years before, they have 3-4 factories. How they, you know, you must have heard about the seafood business. Seafood business, it is started from, the export started from Kerala. The business, seafood business started from Kerala. So I was just, you know, when I was interacting with him, just telling me how he gone down from in this business, having 3 factories in Cochin where the maximum seafood export is to take place. He was discussing about being a PhD, being a dean of university. See, I'm losing every day. He was asking me how you are doing, how's your business.
Bits was put. So what best you have to say here is, as the magnification increases, our area of scanning is tends to zero, maximum information is obtained. Now, for a change, instead of using a microscope, I will use a telescope. You know, telescope can scan a larger area, but it will have less depth of focus. Why I am saying is, the topic that is to be discussed today, or to be delivered today by me, is a very vast one. So I may not be doing justice to give in-depth knowledge of the university education or higher education system. Well, prior to, I would say, 1960, we had an education system which was known under the name Macaulay model, Lord Macaulay model. He's a British man. He introduced this system of education early 19th century England. And he was of the opinion that whatever education given in the East is just useless. He was concerned to use Indian population with giving proper education to use them in administration, particularly at lower cadre. He wanted a lot of clerks for carrying out administration in India. That's why he brought this kind of education system in India. That is not in line with culture and heritage of India. So government of India thought in 1961 that the system should be changed. For this, government of India set up a commission headed by Professor M.S. Thakur, who was the Director General of CSIR New Delhi. CSIR is Council of Scientific and Industrial Research. So a commission was set up and he was asked to overhaul the education system. What was done was just a cosmetic surgery type thing, with the old one with hotspot changes were made. So again in 1980, one more commission was set up with Professor Nayudamma, who was also Director General of CSIR. He also brought in some changes, but still that was not the one that is required by us. Again in 1999, another commission was set up with Professor P. Ramarao, a distinguished professor who started his career at IISc Bangalore, but he was a very recognized professor at Banaras Hindu University, who later became the director of Defense Metallurgical Research Lab at Hyderabad, DMR Hyderabad. And subsequently he became chairman of the Atomic Energy Commission